Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Jakarta, Indonesia. It's the FIBA Asia Cup 2022. It's game day two, and the battle between Jordan and, hey, the host, Indonesia. Well, if you like excitement, then you want to be at the games with the home team, because the fans are, they're going to be in raptures, I think. There are the standings, Australia 2-0, Indonesia trying to join them to decide Group A supremacy. Saudi Arabia 0-2, and Jordan, of course, going for their first win after their loss to Australia. I'm Jeff Taylor, joined by Mark Mills. Mark, we were thrilled, you know, by Marquez Bolden and Indonesia, but this Jordan team that's coming out, they kind of recovered, I think, some self-respect with their finish against Australia the other day.
Yeah, I think so as well. There was a point within that where we were looking at it thinking, wow, this could be a blowout, but they brought it back to within 18, and that's going to give them some momentum heading into today's game. If this was at a neutral venue, we'd look at it and we'd say Jordan are clear favorites. Throw that out the window right now, because the way Indonesia fed off this crowd atmosphere in that first game was unbelievable. Obviously led by Marquez Bolden, and you know, Bolden by nature put in a huge performance for them and led them to that, well, let's be honest, historic win.
It was. We saw El Guari come out. I can't speak highly enough of him for Jordan, and I really think he is an elite big. You know, he should be considered just as elite as Haddadi is for Iran. Now, maybe not overall, over the long haul, but possibly. But he is polished. He's a leader. He gets on the floor for the loose balls. And I think today it's going to be a different game for Marquez Bolden. I think Jordan are going to come up and minimize the impact that he has. That being said, Marquez Bolden is sensational, and he is going to have his moments today. We're going to now listen to the national anthem for Jordan and Indonesia.
We start with the anthem of Jordan. Indonesia.
It's all about passion for your national team, passion for your country, excitement about basketball being on the big stage here in Indonesia, just like it will be next year when this country hosts the FIBA Basketball World Cup, along with Japan and Philippines And Indonesia, of course, the pressures, we look at Dark Tucker, the pressures on them to get to the quarterfinals, because if they do, then they will take up a spot as one of the 32 teams in the competition as one of the host nations. Jordan, however, they have aspirations themselves of having a big time success here at the FIBA Asia Cup, and they also want to be back at the FIBA Basketball World Cup where they have been in the past. And you know what? I don't know why we have to keep being reminded of that, but Jordan are a very good team. They have some lows, but they tend to bounce back and get some highs. And I think today it's a fascinating story for this Jordan team going up against Indonesia and Marques Bolden.
Yeah, it is. And the biggest thing for me for Jordan is not how they play the game, but can they put their loss behind them?
Rabah Nujaim, Glenn Cornelio, and Mohamed Alamiri from Lebanon, Philippines, and Kuwait are doing the refereeing.
It really is down to Jordan now to put that loss behind them. They're a quality team, an absolute ton of talent, and world-class talent. You know, you obviously mentioned Alguery, you know, without a shadow of a doubt, Dar Tucker. He had 20 points, but it felt like he had a quiet game against Australia. But there's several other players. In particular, for me, I think Freddie Ibrahim is going to be important to them if they're going to progress. He needs to be a bit more consistent than he was in that first game. But for Indonesia, you're right, it's a different lineup.
Abu Hawass, Dar Tucker, Freddie Ibrahim, Zaid Abbas, and Ahmad Alguari with Al-Hindi, Al-Harmache, Huzai, Abu Huzane, Hussein, Abbas, and Cannon. Playing for that man right there, the former Jordan national team player himself, Wessam Al-Sous. And expectations are high in Jordan, as they are in a lot of places.
And I kind of like that. I kind of like that, you
as
know,
in Syria, as
countries
in
across Asia are now expecting their teams to come to these big tournaments and come back with medals hanging around their necks.
Well, I mean, Indonesia, Derek Michael, Javiero, Brandon Jawato, Abraham Garhita, Andikara Prastawa, and Marques Bolden. Koko de Putra, Saputera, Noor, Kosasi, Goantara, Wisnu, and Teja, all for Coach Pejic. So we're going to look at Coach Pejic as well. And of course, probably everybody knows the story, how Ryko Toroman was at the helm. And then a late decision right before the FIBA Asia Cup. We understand, like, really late, like the day before the tournament, it was announced that Pejic would move from assistant to head coach. They didn't have maybe the desired results that they had and that they wanted in the last window. I don't think that's any slight against Toroman. He certainly didn't have Marques Bolden in the lineup, so nobody's questioning, perhaps except Indonesia, Toroman, because Toroman has done great work with other countries, including Iran, who he kind of set them on the path with their golden generation. So this is a big game, and if Indonesia win, it'll be a battle for first place for them against Australia. If they lose, you actually have the potential of 3-1-2 teams, and then a goal differential tiebreaker comes into play to determine the second and third place teams. And of course, the second and third place teams go into the qualification for the quarterfinal round. And as good as Bolden is, and he is good, I just can't see Indonesia going up, and if they were to win this game, going out and beating Australia. So I think probably the likelihood is they will get to the qualification for the quarterfinal round, and then it all boils down to who they play and how they play in that game.
Yeah, absolutely. I'm on the same page as you. I think they'll make it through to the qualification for the quarterfinals on the back of their big first game day win. But the question I have is, we didn't really need to see them stretch too far outside of Bolden in their first game. They're going to have to tonight. Other players on this roster are going to have to step in and put some big numbers up on the board to beat Jordan. One, are they ready to do it, and are they capable of doing it?
Well, good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to Jakarta. This is Basketball Central in Asia. It's the third game of the day at the FIBA Asia Cup, and Marquez Bolden goes down and gets his first rebound after Jordan won the opening tip. Jordan wearing the black, attacking the basket to the left, and Indonesia in the white and going to the basket to the right on the screen. And what we saw with Bolden, he played very well, and some of the other players raised their level because of him. It took him a while, though. I mean, really, it was Bolden scoring pretty much everything for the first 5 minutes.
Yeah, and I think that consistent performance from Bolden really gave confidence to his teammates and took some of the pressure off them that maybe they were feeling playing in front of their home crowd in such a raucous atmosphere.
Well, the long jumper, Rajita didn't even have a chance. He got swatted. And Dark Tucker drives down and is blocked and is fouled.
And for me, that's a much brighter start. Ibrahim, you know, getting out, he's intrinsic to what Jordan do. He has to spark that offense. Tucker needs to run lanes off him, particularly in transition. Exactly what happens there. Tucker slightly frustrated. He didn't get the score and go into line for the three-point play. But that's a good first sign for Jordan.
Costello picks up the foul. That's not a good development. Probably their top guard, but Tucker misses the first. But Tucker was very good against Australia, and he was good against Indonesia in their recent World Cup qualifier. They played in the last window, which Jordan won decisively. But again, Indonesia did not have you-know-who. Nobody boxes out. That's Javiero. Did not box out Abbas. And the young Javiero, steep learning curve for him, but that's pretty basic. You got to know, you got to box him out on the missed free throw. Aguari, and winning already that battle with Bolden. Quick pass up to Abbas. Bolden hustles back down, and the charge on Abbas. El Dwari, though, already letting it be known, it's going to be a little bit more physical tonight for Bolden.
Yeah, absolutely. And the smart play is pushing Bolden so far away from the basket. He's not going to be as influential if he's not catching the ball in the low block. If he's forced that far away, don't expect Bolden to have the same stat line that he did in game day one.
Javier with the pump fake, and then lays it up. I thought he was going to dunk it. And maybe at the last second, he decided to lay it up. It's a nice recovery from not boxing out for this free throw for Javiero. The place is still filling up, and it's already loud. Dark Tucker, he misses, but El Dwari goes up, brings it down. Dark Tucker left wide open. And Gajita commits the foul. Can't be the strategy. Surely not to leave wide open jump shooters. That was the foul by Grajita. Look at this. No, maybe he wasn't trying to duck in at the beginning.
No, very soft touch around the ring. That's a good move by.
That's a NBA Global Academy. Oh, the rejection. Well, that was a message from Bolden. Now Abbas. And they wrestled it away. But there was a whistle. Certainly nobody heard it because it was so loud. They battled for the rebound. And Grajita comes up with it. So the competitive juices are flowing here for Indonesia. Jawato, he gets bumped. Passes back outside to Bolden. For three. Got it!
And that is going to be a problem for Jordan because Aldwari does not want to come out and have to contest three-point shots. However, if he makes Bolden work really hard at the other end, potentially he's not going to have to because Bolden just won't have the energy.
Freddie Ibrahim took on Marcos Bolden, and it was about halfway through his move and he realized he was in a bit of a situation. Chapiero missing.
And that's the 19-year-old getting a little bit carried away with the occasion.
El Dwari going right at Bolden, and I don't think he wants to turn this into an El Dwari Bolden match, a matchup or game.
No, that's not the advantage Jordan have got. That's not the, you know, the benefit that they have in their roster.
To Watto! Grajita after the pump fake. And off of Caballero.
But this is what Indonesia needed as well. They needed a good, strong start. It's not about necessarily a big lead, but they need to bring the crowd even more into the game. And the crowd are fully engaged now with their team. They're fully behind them. They think they've got a chance of beating Jordan here, and they're going to try and cheer them to that win.
FIFA Secretary General Andreas Zappos is here watching this game. Of course, he has to be excited to see this atmosphere. It's one of the host nations for the World Cup next year. Freddie Ibrahim bounce pass, El Guari fouled by Bolden.
And I prefer that as an option. If they want to attack Bolden, I fully understand that, particularly if they can draw fouls off him. That could be very influential. But attacking him one-on-one, just trying to grind him down back to the basket, it's not going to be the way. They're going to have to get him to have to move laterally. That's why he's going to be less comfortable on the defensive end.
The first, it is typically a late arriving crowd for whatever reason for Indonesia. It happened on game day one, and it's happening on game day two.
Yeah, it's exactly the same. It just kind of drips and drabs come in as the game progresses and starts, and then by the end of the first quarter we've almost got a completely full arena. Really interesting, but the atmosphere has been electric from the opening tip, so the noise levels are high, that's for sure in here.
Nearly 4 minutes into it, Elguire's free throws cut it to a one-point deficit. Outside, Javiero feet set, count it! Much better.
Yeah, that's a much better option for him. It's built within their offense. They've moved the Jordanian defense around, and then he has the open jump shot. Much calmer, more relaxed opportunity for him.
You can see why Javiero is causing a real buzz. He gets a hand up, and Dar Tucker says, don't forget about me.
And you kind of think, how many arenas around the world has Dar Tucker silenced with the way he plays the game?
Took him a few shots, but he got one to drop. Javiero steps back this time, hits another one.
Wow.
He did the same thing in the recent meeting with Jordan. Hit a couple early threes, but then he went cold.
Didn't hit a single three, though, in that first game, so it wouldn't have been on the scouting report for Jordan to have to chase him out.
All right, Tucker, this time, doesn't get it to drop.
And you feel from Jordan's perspective and Coach Pejic's perspective that you just need to ride this initial storm. They're always going to come out with a ton of energy, maybe not expecting threes like that, but they were always going to come out with a lot of enthusiasm, a lot of energy. Ride this initial turbulence, and it might get a little bit easier for them if they can just keep it close in these early stages.
Pastara sees his attempt rattle out. To me, the player that's got to really get it going is Jawato. El Guari and Javiero is really asserting himself.
Yeah, and you're right with Jawato. If Indonesia are going to come away with the win, he will have to play a big part in this game. When? Who knows, but he will have to.
Oh, great defense, Ibrahim, knocking it away from Bolden. Abbas, look how Ibrahim gets down the floor. Back to Tucker in that corner that he likes so much. Now, Bolden comes in to help out defensively. Back to Tucker on the wing. A great read by Jawato, almost coming up with the steal. He left his man.
That's really smart. And Bolden there couldn't overcommit on the defensive end. He's already picked up that first foul. He knows the second foul will take him to the bench this early in the game. So he can't overcommit. He can't be as aggressive as he wants to be. Jordan looking to exploit that. But Jawato's there to help out in that weak side rotation.
Abbas fades. Well, he did well. Ball just didn't drop, and that's all Guato can do defensively in that situation. Caballero. Boy, he is a high flyer, isn't he?
Excuse me, Mr. Caballero, aren't you aware this is supposed to be all about bowling? But you're stealing the thunder.
Yeah,
the limelight.
This isn't the Bolton show no more. Double digits already. We're only 7 minutes pretty much into the game, and he's already up to 10 points. What a performance so far from him.
Ibrahim this time cruises in. Steady Freddy.
Look out. Much better from Ibrahim.
A wonderful play. Great hustle from El Dwari for the block.
Joato asking for the goaltend.
A nice slash and drive from Tucker. Boy, El Dwyeri protecting that rim. Costawa answers. He needs to contribute, and he does.
Yeah, he had a huge game against Saudi Arabia. 10 points, 9 assists. He was really controlled the tempo and was a facilitator for Indonesia in that big win.
There's Abu Hawass. He can contribute as well. Able to get rid of it. Nice spin from Steady Freddy. Oh, a little bit out of control, though, in the end. Bolden doesn't take any chances, just brings it across midcourt, hands it off to Prestala Javiero. Now Tucker quickly up to Abbas. Great hustle, Javiero. Great finish, Abbas.
Yeah, under a huge amount of pressure as well from Javiero there. He wasn't going to give up the chase. He'll chase down everything on the defensive end.
And good work by Grajita. One thing that we've really seen in this Asia Cup, where some of these teams have been very good about putting pressure on that D and driving hard to the basket.
Yeah, they really have just a couple of changes now rotationally, and I like this from Coach Alzus taking Dwyeri out of the lineup, giving him an extra break, an extended break across that first quarter. We aren't seeing the same for Bolden. Okay, he had a big game in game day one, but he had to play 37.4 minutes. Can he do the same again today in what will be a much tougher game for him?
Here's Wisnu, and Wisnu really needs to raise his game for this Indonesia team. Turns it over, his first contribution, and then the ball goes off of Bolden and out of bounds.
Yeah, it's important that some of the veteran players like Wisnu step up now. A little bit quiet at times in that game day one.
Kukur also in the game, and now coming in is Saputera. Meanwhile, for Jordan, Hashim Abbas and Abu Wazane, who's going to try to put his big body on Bolden. There's, oh wow, Abu Hawass fouled as he gets to the rim. Great play again. I thought he really did pretty well in the second half against Australia, Abu Hawass.
Yeah, he did. To be honest, Jordan just generally did. They showed a lot of heart to fight their way back into that one. They were, you know, on the ropes, really struggling at times early on in that game against Australia. But then they worked so hard to fight their way back in, and, you know, being down by just 18 at the end of the game wasn't a bad result in the end for them.
Chant is Indonesia, the crowd. Wisnu open for three. Now pulls pass up to Tucker, and he's fouled. Twice they've been able to get out and run after a missed three-pointer.
Hits the ground hard and just goes into fetal position, has a little nap on the baseline. Oh, Tucker, phenomenal.
Well, you know what Dora rhymes with? Star.
It does.
There you go. Rhymes with a few other things. I think star is appropriate.
It absolutely is. How many games has Darl Tucker stepped up for Jordan?
He's also raising the bar. So he is at the line, already giving Jordan the lead.
Takes himself up to 8 points now, and this is what Jordan needs from Darl Tucker. He doesn't have to have the ball in his hands a huge amount. He'll still end up with 20 plus points at the end of the game.
I think he also went for Jordan, number six. Bolden spins, turns, puts it up, and he's fouled by Abu Wazano.
It's certainly been a quiet start to the game for Bolden. He needs to get in to his rhythm.
Could have been fouled by Tucker, in fact. But they called it on Abu Wazano. Looked like Tucker actually made more contact.
I think Bolden will get an extended break across the quarter. They're looking to make the changes. Kwesi is sitting on the subs bench.
And again, we see all these, all the supporting cast for Jordan. That's why you have to have the likes of Juwato come out and provide some offense. Javier back in the game. Ooh, this is Booth. 2-point lead for Jordan. And Freddie Ibrahim, they're going to go 2-for-1. Well, Wisnu was boxing out Tucker, so he couldn't go for the basketball. So about a 10-second difference in the game clock and the shot clock. Steady Freddie. Juwato shaking and baking. Out it goes. Zapatero gets it to Bolden. One pass too many.
And this is the problem for Indonesia. Just overpassing. They need a bit more confidence. These role players have to step up.
17-15. Jordan on top of Indonesia at the end of one.
Expected Indonesia facing a much tougher task today. Most of their shooting coming from outside. They've not got it going yet. They'll need to if they want to come away with the win.
Well, this guy was pretty fantastic at the start of the game, Javiero, and already making strides since opening day. Bolden, as he does, comes out and gets the block, but Alguari also had something to say about that at the other end. Bolden did show that three range.
Didn't offer as much in that first quarter as we saw in the first game. Obviously, he's going up against a higher level of defense, and Javiero filled the gap, I think. And
a couple of threes.
Yeah, he took advantage, but the other way, Darl Tucker. He is one of those players. He doesn't need the ball in his hands all the time. He doesn't demand the ball. He doesn't want to be on the ball. But he's just there, he makes the right cuts, the right moves, he spaces well on the floor, and his teammates fully trust him to get the job done on the offensive end.
And there he was, getting out on the break. So they punished him twice after missed free throws. Well, download the Courtside 1891 app for video stream schedules and scores. Just scan in that barcode, folks, and it'll be on your iPhone, or your smartphone, should I say.
Yeah, other brands Android, are available.
various phones. Whichever one you've got, it'll work. Second quarter. They would like to get Bolden the ball down low, but it's going to be Juato missing, especially with no El Dwari in the game.
Yeah, they've got to make hay when El Dwari's taking a rest. And Juato there, you could see it from his shooting form. He's just overstretched. Didn't quite have enough on it.
Three-pointer, well, there's an air ball. Hashim Abbas.
And he's hearing it from the crowd on that air ball.
Well, sometimes we don't get as many minutes. It's a bit hard to get in the flow. Obviously, he can hit that shot, but he wouldn't be taking it. Wisner with the pump fake, gets it to Javiero. Go! Well, he's been the best player today.
He's been absolutely lights out for Javiero.
13 points already, his third three. Dar Tucker.
How many times is Dar Tucker going to be the party pooper here? Already twice he's cancelled out the threes.
Up there is Javier's feet set. Go! Another one is 4 3-pointer.
This is unreal. He's up to 16 points already. He hasn't been in the game the whole game either. He's played over 10 minutes. Phenomenal. You have to remember, he's 19 years old.
Oh, terrific work. Looks like they're going to get another one. Now Juato takes it inside. Wisner swings it over to Javiero. Zapatera, good, right at the line.
And Indonesia continue to ride this almost adrenaline wave that's in the arena. They lead by three now, and Jordan have to stamp this out a bit.
Oh. So the foul on Wisner.
It's a good block, though, by Bolden. It won't go down on the charts because obviously it was a foul, but he was right to knock it away. That was right at the top of the arc. I'm not sure if that had just tipped over.
It's good to see him swat the basketball for Indonesia fans. Just it's a reminder to Jordan that this guy's in there protecting the rim.
Yeah, certainly, any team that faces Indonesia, they don't get an easy time of scoring those buckets around the rim. I'm sure opposition coaches are looking at almost ways to draw Bolden away from the paint. While he's the rim protector, makes it so difficult to get high percentage opportunities close to the basket. So most teams need to have some kind of play built in to try and drag the big out of the paint.
Bazai comes in, Ibrahim goes out, so it might also from a guard advantage. Bazai's got some talent, but here you go, he just got beat there for now. Agassi might be an advantage that this Indonesia team can take advantage of, rather. Wisnu.
He's got to hit those shots. Bolden does a great job on drawing the defense in, collapsing the defense, and Wisnu had all the time in the world for that one.
Dar Tucker. And same for Tucker. Inside both surrounded. So you see the strategy for Jordan. Anytime he gets the touch, he's not just double teamed, he's triple teamed.
Yeah, I think when El Dwari's off the floor, that's got to be the way. That's the only way you're gonna look Bolden down, is force him to pass out the post and just hope that he passes to someone that doesn't hit the three. In this case, just anyone but Javiero, I think, right now.
Here in the corner, the three, got it! Wow! Agassi.
6 from 16 from outside already for Indonesia. They're leaning heavily on the three, which is slightly concerning. Live by it, die by it.
Dar Tucker. Oh, boy, tough drive.
13 points for Dar Tucker now, and he just keeps silencing the crowd. Every time they get up, there's a bit of momentum. He quickly takes it back down again.
Javiero, oh, he's bucked. I really feel like Indonesia are doing what they need to be doing against this defense.
They're doing a great job. On the offensive end, they're doing an absolutely phenomenal job.
Comes a time when you just got to make your shots.
Yeah, the only concern I have is that they are living on the three-pointer right now. And eventually, that will naturally dry up, or Jordan will chase that off the perimeter. What do they do when that dries up? Are they able to get inside to Bolden? Is Zaliero able to change his game to be an interior game?
You talk about the three-pointers drying up, but also I think that D against Bolden is going to dry up. I don't think you can just bottle him up for the entire game. He's going to find his points.
Zaliero. I think eventually they'll have to stop the travel team. They'll have to step away from that because that's what's giving so much space on the perimeter. They'll have to drop it down to either just a straightforward matchup of Bolden or, worst case, a double team. And if that's the case, then expect Bolden to start really putting the points in.
Now Dwari back in the game. One of two at the line. Oh, Tucker, that's a dangerous play by Grajita.
Yeah.
Especially after what we saw last night.
It's an accidental dangerous play. He's not intending to. He's trying to push him out and body him out. And I don't think he actually realizes that Tucker's gone into the air.
Right.
But it's, we saw what happened to 30 Ravena last night. Thankfully, Tucker didn't completely flip.
Gabriel comes up with it.
Just looked up at the stands again and they're just a little bit fuller. Every time I look up, they just seem to be packing out even more as the game progresses. Still people flooding in here in Jakarta.
Javiero. Boy, that was a tough pass. And Grajita clangs it off the backboard.
Yeah, had no real chance, Grajita, there. That was a hope and a prayer.
Adwari, but! And he's got a three-point play.
And maybe more importantly, that's going to be the second foul on Bolden. Still 5 minutes, 49 left in his first half. Interesting to see how Coach Pešić now deals with this. He just looks at Bolden and gives him the universal language of the two hands going down to say, just calm down, don't overplay. And Bolden returns the gesture back to his coach, saying, it's okay, I won't be jumping, trying to block everything now.
Dwari converts the opportunity. I mean, just one of the best players in this tournament. It's not even close, El Dwari.
Yeah, he's going to cause big problems for a lot of teams as they progress in the tournament. He's certainly one of what I would class one of the more sophisticated bigs. He's not, you know, one-dimensional. There's many aspects to his game. There's many different low post moves that he puts in.
Agassi dribbles right, gets it to Bolden. O'Brien comes out to him. He sends it to Grajita.
It's great vision by Bolden. It's a brave pass to put it across the lane like that. It's still very good vision from the big man.
Zai misses. And Dar Tucker with the push.
Neither team at the moment called a... I was just about to say, neither team have called a timeout, which I think tells you how close this game is. Neither team are overly upset with how the game's going. But timeout now called by Indonesia. They clearly want to change something up.
So let's go down to the huddle, see if we can listen in.
Marquis, Lever, Marquis, Marquis, Bob Paul, you diving. You're diving, Marquis, go to Bob Paul. You will be open. Hey, if rotate coming from the corner, step out from the corner, pass or not, shot, open shot.
Okay, did you get it?
One more time? We play reverse short one, yeah. We play with Marquis. side of five. Marquez pop out, you dive.
Okay. Nothing else.
Marquez, open shot, pass to the corner, continue, open shot, continue, pick your own finish.
Okay, let's go.
Hey, come on.
Indonesia with 18 points from outside, whilst Jordan with 14 points in the paint, and we're tied at 27 apiece. Clearly shows you how offensively these two teams work in Indonesia, looking to the outside all the time, whilst Jordan want high percentage chances. Jordan dropping into this 2-3 zone now.
Well, 3-point shot out there for Prestawa. All knotted at 27. 3-point shot there, not there for Jordan. El Dwari with the rebound. Sandwiched between Indonesia's two big men. Still look pretty imposing. Abu Hawass. Good drive, but denied. And the contact down here. Jordan wanted a foul at the other end.
I think they were trying to get a call on Zabiero, and Bolden's having to play very restrained defense now that he's on two fouls. He's not challenging like he was, he's not bodying up Abwari like he was, but his teammates are helping out though. A lot of rotation from the guards coming down to help out in the low post.
Bolden. Agassi, I mean, right now, the supporting cast overall is getting it done.
Yeah, they really are. And this was the big question, you know. Bolden clearly is going to be the target of pressure from Jordan. Can other players stand up at the moment? Yeah, they absolutely can. They're getting the job done.
Jakarta is rocking right now. And the reads and the foul on Prestawa.
Substitution, Jordan.
It's four Indonesian players on two fouls now, no players on Jordan above one. Foul trouble might play its part as this game progresses. Just feel that Indonesia need to be a little bit more careful with the fouls they're giving away.
Pass ripped to Bazai. Al-Hamache tapped the ball and Jordan maintained possession. Freddie Ibrahim fouled on the turnaround. That is just a very poor foul by Prestawa.
Yeah, it's just badly judged. Overcommitting to a shot he didn't need to. He'd forced Ibrahim into taking a very difficult fadeaway shot.
So not only is it a bad foul, but it's his third foul.
Yeah, exactly what I was saying. You know, it's tough to play on two fouls, particularly the emotion that's in the room right now. These guys want to give everything they've got on the defensive end. And to do that when you've got two fouls this early in the game is difficult. You need to temper your intensity.
So he sits down for the rest of the first half. Zapatero in and Freddie Ibrahim back in.
What a game Javier has had so far. He really has been the highlight. We thought it would be the Bolden show, but you're right. It's the Zapatero show right now with 17 points.
Ibrahim, a little bit naive.
I've been much more impressed with Ibrahim tonight. He needed to step up. He struggled in that first game. He's back to where you expect him to be.
Bazai from the elbow. That's it. And it puts Jordan in front.
Indonesia's defensive level starting to drop, which is a concern. It's a part of the game they need to keep high. It's going to drive everything else for them if they can.
Now Bolden, Al-Dwari. And Al-Dwari trying to get in the head of the referee, telling him 3 seconds. Bolden was camping out. Freddie. Oh, my goodness. If that had gone in, that would have been dazzling.
Whenever you go up against Bolton, though, the guards for Jordan having to put it so high. It's almost coming down with snow every time they go up against him.
I need to pick up the dribble, and now you turned it over. Here comes Alhar Mache. Boy, Agassi has to do better. Can't turn the ball over at midcourt. There's no need for him to pick up his dribble.
Yeah, that's an immaturity in the game. Just 22 years old, and it's not the right move. You'd almost rather have that 5 second, you know, held up call or even throw the ball away. You can't be passing back to your own basket.
Bolden keeps it. That's the shot that he practices.
Yeah, and that's the right time to call a timeout. Bolden just starting to bubble away. Not a boiling point yet, not that warm, but just starting to bubble away. Call the timeout, break that momentum. Really good coaching from Alsous there. I think that's exactly right. Bolden could be a huge threat for them. They need to kind of cool him down as much as they can.
Now, we're on the 45 side. Okay, 45 side. For Sam, it's not his side. You want the side, this side. So Sam will be here. Hamash is coming out. Pass and drop. Then I can see it. If, watch me. 45 side. Okay, for Sam. Now, if nothing happened after that, okay, Sammy, pick a roll. Pick a roll with Dwayne. If you don't have the shot, early shot, Dwayne. Pick, roll, boom. 22s, have two fouls. Let's go a little bit, Tucker. Attack him, okay? The next offense, when we're coming back, let's run one after. I know, but after, let's run one.
I think we're still waiting on Jawato to really kind of lend a helping hand, so to speak, in the scoring department.
Yeah, I think on the defensive end, he's there. The level is right. He comes in and really helps down. Plays above his size for sure. But if Indonesia are wanting the big win and to secure their spot out of the group, he is going to have to step up. He's going to probably have to get to double digits because it's not going to be the Marquez Bolton show on that.
Desai from the top. Alhar Mache, very active. Look at him getting the basketball. That just can't happen for Indonesia. You got four white shirts, and he's the only black shirt, and he comes up with the basketball.
And every team at this level needs an Alhar Mache that just steps up, hustle, chases lost causes. Great to have players like that in your team.
Coco to Petra for three. Chance of defense here in Jakarta. Dar Tucker gets rejected by Bolden. That was sensational. He had to keep an eye on Alguari. And then he turns to the last second. Great move by Jawato. They swing it. Nice passing. Oh, and then one pass by Saputera way off target. I think he even caught Alguari by surprise. But Dar Tucker, oh! They call the block.
Yeah, I don't think they're going to give the continuation. I think they're calling the blocking foul.
That was the block. Yeah. Sensational effort by Bolden.
And it's brave by Bolden as well on two fouls to go to the ring with someone.
I think his instincts took over there.
Yeah, I think so as well. If you thought about it, it wouldn't have happened. And there's a replay of the string music three, but another breathtaking phase of play.
They got the score right. I thought Indonesia had taken the lead with that go-ahead, with that three-pointer.
I'm wondering whether they've... Yeah, they've...
Oh, but now, yeah, sorry, now it's Tucker that makes the shot.
They gave the continuation on that play, that last play. They gave the continuation. That's why Jordan in the lead.
Tough break for Indonesia, but... Things even out.
Still concerned that Indonesia are leaning so heavily on the three-pointer. They've attempted twice as many shots outside the perimeter line than they have inside.
Well, this is the break, the foul on Al-Gwairi, the break for Indonesia, because Bolden now goes to the line. And he's tied it.
And he'll be relieved at that after missing his first two attempts. He was flawless from the line in the first game. Well, flawless from pretty much every department in the first game.
Chance of MVP. MVP ringing throughout the arena. I think maybe they should also say that when Chapiero is in the game. Ball goes over to the ref. Timeout. Jordan head back over to the bench. And it really is confirmation that Indonesia are a much better team than what we saw in the recent Asian qualifiers for the FIBA Basketball World Cup.
Yeah, they are more than just making up numbers here, right? They have come into this tournament fully focused. And you do have to give a huge amount of credit to the crowd. You really do. The energy that they've brought to both their games so far, you can clearly see the players are feeding off it. The national pride that they must feel representing their country on home soil in a big tournament like this. Obviously, you know, the ultimate goal would be to lift the Asia Cup, but realistically the big goal that they have is, yeah, that quarterfinal. You know, that quarterfinal spot. Imagine what this arena is going to be like if they can make it to a quarterfinal. It's just going to be off the charts. Jakarta will be rocking if they do that.
This is just a great matchup, Al-Gwairi and Bolden. And when Al-Gwairi's not in there, it's all hands on deck guarding Bolden. Bolden, meanwhile, protecting the rim at the other end. And you can see he's got 9 points, 6 rebounds, 2 blocks tonight, which, in fairness, is really solid, especially the way that he's being played. He's not forcing up shots. Oh, the back door. How about that? And that was a great play for Jordan. They go back in front.
That was poor defense from Goentala, though. Just didn't cover that backdoor cut at all. Got caught sleeping.
Hey, is that Glenn? Is that Glenn man to man? Quick office. Quick office, 5 second max. With him? Yeah, you go down, pop out, shot. Go for one, try to play full set office. Okay? If they set the zone, play full set.
Full set.
Full set. We play times. We play times. Full set. Man to man, short. Let's go, let's play.
Let's go, wiggle.
Yeah. Team on three. 1, 2, 3.
Yeah, they're going to come out of that timeout then and try and go 2 for 1 with the remaining 34.7 seconds. Just calm coaching.
I don't know why Agassi went over to help Ibrahim, who's running towards the Jordan bench there. He was just out of position.
Yeah, completely.
Because he was covered.
Completely lost his
assignment. There was already a man guarding him. So, well read by Freddie Ibrahim. If they get up quickly, they might get 2 for 1.
Should take their time now.
Yeah.
That's smart.
Well, they're going to put it up, and Bolden, oh, that was close to getting the third foul. He was coming over the back.
Yeah, a lot of times just coming over the back like that, you'll get the foul called against you. So Bolden is using up some of his 9 fives in this game so far.
So a new 14 on the shot clock.
Needs to get it in.
Oh, my goodness. Tapatera. Right into the hands of Abu Hawass. Al-Gwairi, shot clock winding down. And Bolden puts him off the shot just enough. While not picking up his third foul. So it's as good as we expected. Jordan lead it by a point over Indonesia, 39-38 at halftime.
Davis Asia Cup is truly the gift that keeps on giving right now. Another absolute storming game we've got. Indonesia living and on that three-pointer, though, and it's concerning if they want to come away with the win. Jordan getting the business done down low in the paint. Even on the rebounding battle, Indonesia maybe playing a little bit more team basketball. It's interesting to see Jordan only having four assists for 39 points. Xaviero, the youngster, with 17 points, and Tucker with 15 for Jordan. But yeah, just an amazing first 20 minutes of basketball again.
So we saw Xaviero just really catch fire. You can see hitting that three-pointer. He had four in the first half. Seems like maybe he could have played a little bit more. I don't know what the situation was with Coach Pajic keeping him out.
Yeah, it's an interesting one. I agree with you. When a guy's hot like that, he did play 15 of the 20 minutes, though, so it wasn't exactly a low number. But when a player's feeling it like that, and when he's young, he's got young legs, he can play more minutes than 15 in the 20. But there was a moment that you saw in that first half. He missed a three, and maybe they felt, well, you know, his flow's gone a little bit. Let's give him some extra time, and he can sit down, composure, and come back out and contribute again. But for his age, what an unbelievable performance in a, you know, a real intense atmosphere.
Points in the paint is really interesting to me as we look at the highlights. Jordan had 22, just 8 for Indonesia. And it just kind of illustrates how they have relied on that three-point shot, 7 of 22 for three-point range, whereas Jordan are just 2 for 10. So,
yeah, real contrast in the playing styles from these two teams.
And Jordan also winning the rebounding battle. Al-Dwari, we talk about all the pressure that he's under tonight. He hasn't actually shot it that well. He's only 1-7 from the floor. He's got 5 points, but to go with that, 8 rebounds, a couple of steals, and a couple of blocks.
And
one block. And
he's had drawn three fouls, though, which is obviously going to contribute to a factor to his shooting percentage. They're not letting him play. You know, they've clearly targeted him and said, look, if we can keep Al-Dwari out of the game, we have a higher percentage chance. My concern also is looking at how many times Jordan went to the free throw line. 13 free throws in the first half compared to just 6 for Indonesia. Indonesia needs to be more aggressive in the paint to draw those fouls. Just living on the perimeter, I have a feeling it's going to eventually dry up. And when it does, what do they do? Is Bolden going to be able to dominate the paint? I'm not sure he will here against an impressive Jordan front court.
We know that Juato, we know also Xaviero can put the ball on the deck and probably have a pretty good chance of not having the shot block, just like Bolden. Anyway, 39-38, Jordan on top of Indonesia at halftime.
Who will you become when the moment arrives and you're carrying the expectations of an entire nation? Representing your people and their dreams, the colorful faces in the streets, the screaming fans in the stands. It's time to make your move. All eyes on you, all hope, all heart. Because when you win for all.
Chance to run, a rare chance, and here he goes, Nazarian, and nobody gets the score. What an incredible finish from Nazarian. Give credit where it's due, he did not want to charge. So he pauses right at the end. Bounce pass, and Gavrilov flushes it. Here's Timmons driving in and throwing it down. We saw him miss one early. He wasn't going to miss that one, was he? Kalamura, look at him. Another pass to the corner. Good! Right at the buzzer. Deadeye, Yudai Nishida, another three for him. And again, look at the pass. Goodness! Ready for takeoff for one.
quick first step as well, and he just left Parks completely in his dust as he flew past him.
Oh, good play, India. Hey, they're getting out running. They look good. They look a lot better than anticipated. Sherbak to Gavrilov, pump fake, his baseline, he gets blocked right at the rim by Watanabe. Look at this.
Not in Jakarta, my friend.
Look at Bobby Ray. Bounce pass. Oh, that was a slick one. And now another slick bounce pass. And Gilas. Good basket.
That pass from Plumbau was absolutely perfect. So difficult to make those passes, not to catch legs, not to just turn the ball over. Oh, there's the block.
Yeah, Arlich.
Cedars are showing us something right now, folks.
Ah, it's beautiful precision and the baseline cut as well.
And they get over this time. Navarro.
It's a Navarro flush. Abando was asking for the alley-oop pass and Navarro said, nah, I've got this one.
Well, Mark, what do you think about Dar Tucker's performance so far?
Dar Tucker does what Dar Tucker does. It's just so consistent, game in, game out. He steps up, puts points in, and he seems to enjoy more than anything else the pressure moments. When, you know, things aren't going Jordan's way, he's the one that steps in, hits big shots like that, and's willing to take some of that. He's almost a release valve on the offensive end for his team. When they need him to step up, he almost does every single time, year after year. What a career he's had, and continues to get it done.
Well, he certainly delivered tonight.
He has been a real servant to Jordanian basketball and continues to do so.
And I think this kind of caught us a little bit by surprise, even though we realize he's a great talent. Michael Javiero.
Yeah, coming into this tournament, I just looked at him and I thought, this is going to be a good development tournament for him, but it's probably going to be the next one where he really steps up. It's going to be the next Asia Cup where he really, you know, comes to the fore. And he's taken the opportunity with both hands. You always have concerns when you see, you know, a 19-year-old being given so much responsibility, starting five member, you know, your home tournament. But he's just relished in it. In the first game, he was absolutely pumped for it and gave everything. And in this game, he's been a little bit more composed, but his range is phenomenal. He is a real handful for Jordan to deal with.
Yeah, I think what I liked about it is he didn't have a great first game. He needed to be consoled, needed to be kind of encouraged. And he's come back with a strong performance today.
And I think that's one of the other great things about having Bolden in that team, that he provides that mentor to Javiero and what, you know, how Javiero needs to develop into kind of the international superstar that it looks like he could potentially be.
So is Jakarta, you can see it's alive and well and interested in basketball. It's not one of the powerhouses of Asia, but it will be one of the host nations for the FIBA Basketball World Cup 2023, along with Japan and Philippines. And the hope here in this crowd, all the players, is that these players will not be sitting in the stands with the fans watching games, but will be on the court being watched by the fans. They have to get to the quarterfinals of this FIBA Asia Cup for that to take place.
And the way they've played so far, you know, we're a game and a half into their Asia Cup. They can absolutely make it to the quarterfinals. Prior to the tournament, I'm not going to lie, I put my hands up. I thought that was a really big ask.
Yeah,
that was a big barrier, a big, you know, hurdle for them to climb to get to the quarterfinals before the tournament. And I'm not sure it is such a big barrier for them. It's still a big ask, but not to that extent. I think there is a realistic possibility that we could see Indonesia at the World Cup next year and them in a quarterfinal of an Asia Cup.
Yeah, that would be huge. I mean, already they've, I think, kind of captured the imagination and showed, you know, that they're a country that has possibilities.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. And it's, if they can come away with the win here today, it would be a really big statement from them as where they are on their development path as a basketball nation. Like you say, it's not necessarily known for its basketball, but by the crowd we've got here and by the way the national team are playing, it's clearly going in the right direction. They're making the right moves. Coach Pešić is doing a great job of keeping his team, I think, their emotions in check. That's been really, really helpful, but everything's looking positive.
If we look ahead, I think realistically, you know, because they also play Australia, and I just feel like Australia, just as I said earlier, they're just going to be way too good for this team.
Yeah,
if they could finish second, Indonesia, they, you know, the Group A crosses with Group B for the qualification round. They would play the third place team from Group B. So that's going to be, I'm guessing, in all likelihood, Chinese Taipei. Now, we haven't seen China play Chinese Taipei yet.
Yep.
But it is likely going to be Chinese Taipei if Indonesia finish second. If they finish third, then I think the likelihood is that they would play China.
Yeah, so realistically, trying to finish second within this group is really important.
And even that illustrates how big of an ask it is, because if they have to play Chinese Taipei, that is going to be a tough game.
Yeah, it truly is.
But what do you want? This is a FIBA Asia Cup.
It's going to be tough. It's got to be tough.
Yeah.
It's not worth winning if it's not tough, right?
Let's go. Stay together, play together. Let's go. Hey. Go. Team on three. One, two, three. Hey.
If they do get to that qualification for the quarterfinals as well, that will be a hot ticket in town. And this arena has been absolutely bouncing for the first two games.
Absolutely. Download the app, folks, for the FIBA Asia Cup information. Got everything you need there. All the information about these teams, the results, you name it. Xavier is starting in the second half with Agassi, Jawato, Prestawa, and Marquez Bolden. It's going to be Aldwari, Tucker, Freddie Ibrahim, Zaid Abbas, and Abu Hawass for Jordan, who lead it by one. And Jordan have possession. They'll be attacking the basket to the right. So Freddie Ibrahim, Tucker, Abu Hawass, Zaid Abbas, and Aldwari. Second half underway in Jakarta between Jordan and Indonesia. Freddie Ibrahim pulling the strings of point guard for Jordan. And Abu Hawass drives in and is fouled by Agassi. That is a big time move, and we've seen that from Abu Hawass, increasingly a threat to put the ball on the deck and get to the basket.
And Agassi's making several mistakes now. I think from my perspective, I'm Coach Pešić, I think I'm taking him out of the game. I think the
the event at the moment is maybe a bit too much for him. He's making some very basic mistakes. He gave up a backdoor cut late in the half. There's ticky-tack fouls now. I think it's worth maybe getting him settled down and bringing someone else on the floor.
Kristawa gets in there quickly. I'm not sure that's what you want either on your first drive. Nobody was, I mean, maybe the problem was nobody went in there for the offensive rebound. Freddie Ibrahim, look out. And Bolden rebounds the miss.
And Bolden well on the way to his double-double, 9 points and 8 rebounds now.
And I think, Kostala again launches a three.
And there's no one there to crash the boards. The entire Indonesian team are just sitting on the perimeter. Uh-oh.
Look out. And Prastawa holding his face.
Yeah, it's just that right elbow, wasn't it, from Dar Tucker that catches him. Oh, yeah.
Little shot. I wonder if they didn't call a foul. They're not going to look at it.
I don't see that as a foul. It's Prastawa who's lowering down to Dar Tucker's elbow. It's not Dar Tucker who's picking his elbow up to the height of Prastawa's head.
Might knock him into life a little bit. It was pretty sharp to the chin.
Yeah, the slow-mo would be good on that one.
Bolden for three.
And came off the wrong part of his hand. You saw they got lodged a little bit too close to the palm. Didn't get the flick on the fingers.
Perfect Tucker. Need to get Javier Juato involved. Abu Hawass, oh wow. Jordan could not have started any better.
Yeah.
And Indonesia could not have started any worse.
Yeah, both ends of the floor. Jordan coming out a lot more focused in the second half, and a 4-0 start to the second half. Clearly that's going to push coach into calling the timeout.
How about Abu Hawass? Terrific. Scan it in, folks. Get it right now into your smartphone, and you get all the stats and much more for this FIBA Asia Cup.
You play one. First off, this one. Don't rotate against Abbas. Don't rotate. Don't rotate. Who cares for his shot? Ball guy. Hey, stay here in the corner. This is the shooter here. Only fake against Abbas. Go back. Hey. Brass, we play two times reverse, yeah, boy. Come on, play one. Play one. Let's go.
So, no reason to get out and guard Zaid Abbas. And that was the problem. Tucker.
Yeah, it's been a phenomenal start. That 7-0 run is. Open the game out.
Biggest lead of the game.
And this is the testing moment for Indonesia now. You know, a slightly more backs against the wall situation, a tougher place for them to play from. It's much easier when you're either very close or you have the lead yourself. How do they use this as motivation to push on again?
Oh boy, Javiero just held it out there for Freddie Ibrahim and he packs it in. Jordan mean business now, and they've got as much riding on this as Indonesia when you think that they want to finish second in the qualifications, at least as high as second.
That's a poor pass.
Knocking it away from behind. Here's Juato, and the ball batted into the hands of Freddie Ibrahim. They're just playing at a different level now, Jordan.
Yeah, they really are. Both ends of the floor, they've turned it up. For Malgwari, I'm giving Holden the three now. I'm almost daring him to shoot the three. I don't think he's confident enough to put one up.
Wow, that was just a quality move. Quality. That is just a superstar move in a very difficult situation where your team needs a bucket.
But we've seen that from Bolden. He's happy to take a leadership role with this team.
Abu Hawass again. Wow. This is their quarter.
Yeah, it truly
the
is.
The shots are falling.
The rims are in their favor.
But Abu Hawass standing up, boy. 3 baskets for him. A couple of jumpers, including a three. and also the drive. Cristal pulls up, that's off.
And they're being too quick on their options, Indonesia.
And they're lucky that Abu Hawass missed a layup. I agree with you. I mean, Cristal needs to realize who buttons the bread. Oh, he's going to put up another three.
And this is where the inexperience of these Indonesian players really comes to show, and it's going to hurt them. They need to understand tempo and emotion, and when they're in this hole, slow things down. Start to try and assert some control on the game, which they don't have right now.
Abu Hawass, shot clock about to expire. Abu Hawass, why did they leave him? And again, the handoff, all the great block. Oh, Bowling just picked up his third.
And he only picked it up because he fell asleep. That's great defense by Xaviero. Phenomenal. He made the mistake in the first place. He didn't chase and didn't stay in front of his man, but he made up for it. But Bolden just caught sleeping. He was ball watching. And Tucker picks up the rebound off that huge block. And that's Bolden's third.
So the guard play has not been good in this half for Indonesia. So the change has been made. Drahita Sapatera comes in. And the lead now 11 points. You know, this Indonesian team didn't have Bolden and Javier playing at the level they are right now. Clearly, you would feel like it's over, but yeah, it's not.
No,
they got to hunker down.
Yeah, they do. And they need to, I'm preferring this. There's a bit more control and structure to their offense. It's not just trying to rely on individual talent and free flow.
Drahita for three.
And that's what you get. That's the reward you get. Lean on your team. Play team basketball and you will be rewarded. That's much better from Indonesia.
Don't just dribble up and take pull-up threes. Oh, boy. Tucker. Ball fell to him. That was nice. Now Abu Hawass. Tucker. Nope, that's off. Aguari. Wear the white shirts for the rebound. Tucker again. Third bite of the cherry. And tough finish. And great job by Javier finally to get the ball. Looks like Tucker is going to get his way.
They need to slow it down, though, Indonesia. They don't need to rush.
Javier! I'm speechless by how well he's played tonight.
It's phenomenal. You know, he's taken on pressure situations, and not just pressure situations. That's not the best shot. I stand by my comment that they should slow that down. But to have the composure to take an off-balance, falling out-of-bounds shot and get it to go, that's the makings of a superstar. To assert their dominance pre-game, and for the neutral, you would say Jordan are the favorites of this game. It didn't look so much like that in the first half at times. The opening stage of this third quarter, they clearly did that. But the amount of respect that keeps growing for this Indonesian team, they're fueled by their fans, but they're not giving up. They're going to fight until the final possession, and reducing it down to a 7-point ball game, that absolutely puts them back in the hunt.
It's interesting, Xavier will be playing in college basketball next year at Grand Canyon University. First ever player from Indonesia to play NCAA Division I. That's a big deal. And he'll get better over there. There is the miss, but they have to be excited watching
him play in this FIBA Asia Cup.
Boy, how the momentum has shifted all of a sudden.
Kahita.
Well, he had hit the 1-3. Still came early in the shot clock.
We said it in the halftime, though, you live by the three, you die by the three, and it feels maybe that's the way that Jordan are going.
Hamas. And Bolden rebounds if they've got numbers if they hurry. Bolden for three. I think he felt Tucker coming from behind him.
So they were 33% shooting from three in the first half. They're now 20% in the second half. This is the problem that we were talking about. They have to find a way to score, and it's through patience on the offensive end for Indonesia.
Freddie Ibrahim has it knocked out of his hands. He puts it up for three. And it misses everything, so they get the basketball back. I mean, they were close, Jordan, to delivering a knockout. You felt like it. They were close.
Yeah.
They were a couple of baskets away. And now, Indonesia, if they can get Bolden down low and maybe Javier on the drive. Juato's going to launch it.
We kept saying it, you live by it, you die by it. They have to run an offensive set that creates an interior opportunity, or at least a driving opportunity. They can't just lean on their perimeter game. It's not paying off right now.
Yeah, I agree. The thing is, Juato can drive. Xaviero can drive. Oh, good defense from behind. Oh, now Glowry gets it right back. Ibrahim hands it off to Zaid Abbas. Reset the shot clock because of the turnover. Tucker, you don't want to leave him open. For three, that's all. Oh, he banked it in!
Look at the smile on his face as he runs back down the floor. The sun is shining on Dar Tucker today with that shot.
Wow, that was huge. The bank. Toronto, wow. Bolden, extraordinary passes, swing it. Kahita, they're just in a rush, and they're lucky Jordan turned it over.
Yeah, Bolden signaling to his teammates to slow down and calm down, but with that rebound, that Bolden on his double-double. 11 points, 11 rebounds for Bolden now. And there's the three from Dar Tucker. And look at the smile as it goes in off the bank, but I don't think he can believe how lucky he was in that situation, but luck favors the brave.
Xaviero hands it off. Bolden, not able to roll to the basket. Kahita, here's Xaviero, he's got the advantage, steps back. Abdul Hawass sticking to him like glue, even he. I'd like to see him maybe try to spin and get to the basket.
Whatever they do, even if it's a tough shot, start collapsing that defense. Start misshaping the defense from Jordan. You've got to take it to the basket. There has to be some action within a meter of the ring. It can't all be fading away. It can't all be perimeter shots. And I'm sure Coach Pešić is going to do exactly that. He needs to find a different option.
Foul Juato for holding.
It's not the worst foul in the world. They're not in the penalty. It's only Juato's second foul.
Yeah. Jordan have not committed a foul in this third quarter.
And why is that? Because Indonesia refused to go anywhere near the basket.
Yeah, you're right.
They're quite happy shooting threes. You don't need to foul someone when they're shooting the three.
Ibrahim. Aguari. Wow.
And that's
the big man.
That's Aguari taking Xaviero to school. That's saying to him, young man, this is how you play inside.
Yeah. It's a 12-point lead. Wow, the three-pointer, Sampradetta, not his first jump shot, his second, but that from the three-point variety.
It just puts a little plaster over the massive crack in Indonesia's offense, though.
Ibrahim, well, he's happy to launch it, and that does him a favor. Does Indonesia a favor. So we'll try to hold it for one.
It's got to be at the basket.
You got to send people to the boards here.
It's got
to
be at the basket. That's a great foul.
Yep.
That's
plenty
a very smart foul.
Yeah, plenty of fouls to give.
They made them run 15 seconds off the clock. If Indonesia had thought about it, a little
they
bit more ball
earlier.
Movement, yeah. Draw those fouls early. Force them into fouling you earlier. I'd be tempted to take Bolt now at this point. I know it sounds crazy, but I'm not sure I'd risk him for 6.9 seconds if he picks up a ticky-tack foul.
Boy, that was a dangerous pass. And it was indeed turnover. And Tucker. I think you got to know who you're going to throw the lob to. I mean,
Abu Wazana is not that bad.
No, I don't think so. Tucker's smiling now.
So that's a missed opportunity. Be interesting to see if it hurts him in the end. Jordan, though, on top, 57-48 over Indonesia at the end of three.
And we said it in the halftime break, you live by the three, you die by the three, and that's the way Indonesia going right now. Just one made three in that quarter. Makes it exceptionally difficult for them to stay in the game because they've relied heavily on that.
Well, Abu Hawass just is all over the highlights for the way he started with the drive. He got to the free throw line. Then Freddie Ibrahim got the steal as well, threw it off the glass. But Bolden helped them stay close. He's got 11 points and 11 rebounds. Grajita hit a big three-pointer. Xaviero hit a tough shot. And Indonesia were right back in it, pulling to within 7 points. But Dar Tucker banked in. That was a huge shot in the grand scheme of things.
what a face he pulled off the back of it. For me, though, at the moment, Indonesia are just hanging by a thread. That's how it feels.
Sampatera answered with a three, but yeah, it's better to be lucky than good, really.
I think that's how Indonesia feel right now. That's so, for sure. But I think they're hanging by a thread.
So Wisnu's checking into the game.
Certainly going to have to play at a higher level than he has so far this evening.
And Prastawa as well. So Jawato goes out. Pushing Bolden out. Grajita, good! And but you got to tip your hat to him and Sampradetta. They've been able to make some shots.
They've kept the scoreboard ticking over, and it's so important when you are struggling that you at least see those points ticking through.
57-51, Bazai misses on. Again, Ahar Marche gets the rebound. They've got to get after those boards. Dar Tucker, shoes off. And finally, Bolden able to get one. And they're going to call timeout as Grajita was about to run off the court to tie his shoe. You know, it really was. It felt like it just wasn't going to happen. And all of a sudden, once again, down six after Grajita's. Is that his third three? The second three.
Yeah, both his field goals. So he's only 2 from 7 from the field. So what a time to start hitting some shots in the clutch. But I like what Jordan are doing here at this stage of the game. They've taken Alguerri off the floor, and instead they've brought in Abu Wazni just to wear down Bolden. He's leaning on him, he's pushing him, he's harassing him. Exactly what you see, and that's fine. I think that's absolutely fine. The more that they can take off the battery of Bolden, the better. Because when it comes down to that crunch point, they're going to bring in a very fresh Alguerri, and Bolden's just not going to have the energy to compete.
Well, I don't know how fresh Alguerri will be.
He'll be fresher than Bolden.
Well, he'll be rested, definitely. He'll still have his hands full. But I take your point. Xaviero, that's what they need. The great physical play by Alejandro Maché, and nobody was there for the follow.
That's the key. No one following, crashing the offensive glass.
Of course, really handy to have Alejandro Maché come in and play important minutes of these games. Oh, great block. Boy, I'm not sure John Tucker knew that was coming.
Hear the slap off the glass from outside the arena.
Risnu passes to Xaviero. And then throws it. He thought Grajito was going to be on a little bit further on the wing.
John Tucker getting to know the cameraman a little bit better on that play.
Alguerri back after that great swat. Abu Wazani did what he needed to do.
It's interesting that he's only run it for 1 minute 40 without him, though. Oh, and there's your swap, and now you can see what they'll do is they'll look to the interior a little bit more as they're looking to bring Tucker out and bring Ibrahim in.
What was that about with the socks? What was that about? I'm totally confused. Have to ask about after the game. Anyway, Alejandro Maché. He's been big. Ibrahim also back. Here he is. Alejandro Maché, he can shoot it and he can make it. And that just puts an exclamation mark on his impact on the game.
Yeah, it really does. He's that kind of player that just fills in the holes. What do you need him to give? And that's what he's going to provide to the team. Xaviero, though, looking tired now. Starting to look tired. Didn't chase him out.
Well, how about Wisnu? I did not expect that. Fortune favors the brave.
Yeah, it's true.
Alejandro Maché, will it be two in a row for him? No, it will not.
Much better defense from Xaviero there. He learned his lesson, chased it out, got a hand out in front of Alejandro Maché.
Nice spin, Prestawa over to Bolden. How sweet was that? The left-handed hook, such a soft shot. It hits the iron and falls through.
They have to get him involved on the offensive end and not giving him the ball on the perimeter. They have to give him the ball down in the block in the low post or when he's cutting to the basket.
And that's where the penetration from Prestawa works. And Ibrahim was falling down. Had to get the shot up quick. Grajita. Oh! Unbelievable. Indonesia closed the gap to three.
In the cold light of day, that's just really bad decision making, but you have to love him for that bravery to go into the amongst the trees.
Grajita has been an absolute stunt today. Ibrahim, what a terrific brave drive after he just messed up on the previous.
And Jordan
possession.
Needed that score because they needed to calm down the atmosphere here. The crowd were getting way too involved for Jordan.
Oh, Wisnu. I can't understand that play. I mean, I know he's trying to get it to the corner, but man, that is a bad time for that turnover.
Sounds silly, but the play will stem from just poor footwork. Didn't step around his defender to create the space and the angle he needed to get the pass away. Ends up trying to lean around his defender and that's always going to be difficult then to get the right angle.
Abbas coming back into the game. The crucial drive by this man, Freddie Ibrahim, followed by the turnover. And Jordan breathing a little more comfortably. Here's Ibrahim again. And Prestala picks up foul number four. And Al-Dwari had words with Prestala and the crowd. Letting Al-Dwari
Zabiero needs to step away, though. He doesn't need to get involved. It's the last thing Indonesia right now. Yes, he wants to stick up for his teammate, particularly as there's a bit of a size difference between Prestala and Al-Dwari, but it's just not needed. A little bit of handbags, it felt like there. Nothing much more than that. The crowd don't need anything more to get them into this game.
Okay. Dwari took a shot. Maybe where it hurts and let him know about it. Ibrahim. Oh, man. You're running out of words to describe it. It's a combination of Alejandro Marche being doing what he's supposed to do. Oh, you can see Wisnu was doing what he was supposed to do.
Prestala just watched the game. He wasn't taking part in that defense at all. He was no use to Indonesia in that defense. He has to, even if he's not able to box out, he had to step across and bump the Jordanian player from jumping through on him like that. Alejandro Marche, I think it was, that got the rebound. It can't let him get those rebounds. You've got to put a body on him. But on the other side of that,
they didn't score.
Of what Alejandro Marche does for a career, right? That's the signature part of his game.
What I like about Alejandro Marche is he just does what the coach asks him to do.
Yeah.
He can start.
Yeah.
He's not ticked off if he doesn't come in until the second half.
No.
He's a winner. He's doing it for Jordan.
That's it. As long as there's a win on the scoreboard at the end of the game, he considers that job done for him.
And you know those Jordan players relishing this environment.
Oh, they love it. They absolutely love it. This
Ibrahim.
Is wonderful.
Oh, what happened here?
I think Wisnu.
Is it Bolden?
Yeah, it's Wisnu, I think.
It's Wisnu.
Yeah.
But that takes him up to three fouls. Okay, three team fouls. Can't give away an easy one like that.
No.
No passes into the lane on inbounds. This time goes to Dwari. Al-Dwari now. Abdul Hawass is good on the drive. Got to guard him.
Shot clock running down, though. He's got to get it away.
Good defense. Oh, he still made it.
That is ice cold. To have the composure to read the shot clock like that, man, that's phenomenal.
He's been terrific in the second half, Abu Hawass. Great drive indeed by Sakutera.
Alejandro Marche looks like he's injured, though. He's hobbling really heavily as he comes back up the floor. I think he's just turned his ankle slightly.
Alejandro Marche, yeah, it might.
He's never going to come out of the game.
No. But, oh, good defense by Sakutera. You know, Abu Hawass has scored 10 of his 13 points in the second half. He and Alejandro Marche have just been really giving this Jordan team a lift. Zapatera has as well. And Grajita. What they need is Bolden to really start making some plays if they can on both ends. Abbas, Javier will win for the block. And the veteran, Abbas, hits the two, the long two.
And you see how Jordan responds to that, though. There's no celebrations, there's no getting excited, because the expectation is they should be winning this game. They should be making those shots.
Oh, great. Look, alert play by Grajita. Terrific.
Yeah, that's
wasn't
smart.
Wasn't standing around. And Al-Dwari. His defense has just been really difficult for Bolden to contend with.
Oh, he's absolutely owning Bolden right now in that low post. Bolden needs to work harder to establish himself. I don't know if it means he has to come from the weak side to try and get closer to basket space to work with. Whatever he needs to do, he has to become a factor in this game. And the way he's going to be a factor is not on the perimeter. It's going to be in the paint.
And now, Jar Tucker back in the game. And I think doing everything he can to annoy the crowd. So let's see if that backfires.
He's played in enough hostile countries. I saw him play in Argentina not so long ago, and yeah, he's used to hostile territory, that's for sure.
Basketball, you love it. International basketball, it's even better. And it's happening right now, the FIBA Asia Cup in Jakarta. Freddie Ibrahim, Jordan, trying to get a big win, their first win, and Al-Bawri throws it down. Abbas, all he's done is come back into the game, make a big shot, and then get down on the baseline and curl a pass to Al-Bawri.
I think that's a key moment in this game. That really felt like a key moment.
Zapatero telegraphed the pass, but then he hustles back. Oh, great hustle from Indonesia, from Ibrahim as well. The game opens up. And Zapatero, can you believe it? Oh, heartbreaking. Granjita.
Absolutely breathtaking. It's one of those phases of play.
Yeah, I mean,
this is just so passionate, so much pace in this game. Both sets of players. They'll be glad they've got a rest day tomorrow. They wouldn't want to come out of this game and have to go again tomorrow. And there's still 3 minutes and 43 seconds left. What a showcase.
Must score possession here. And they're laying it all on the line. Grajita, Zapatera, Jawato back, Bolden, and Javiero. And Javiero falls down. Oh, excellent work. And Grajita gets inside. Unbelievable. Unbelievable.
They do not know how to give up. They are showing so much spirit now. This isn't about skill set or experience.
It's about heart.
That's all it's coming down to. They are showing how much pride they have in their national team and putting everything on the hardwood right now.
And how desperate they are to make this tournament a success for Indonesian basketball. But Abu Hawass has just been an ice-cold killer in the second half.
Just surgical, the way he's playing the game right now.
12 and 15 points in the second half. Jawato. Javiero with the shot clock winding down. Bolden for three. It's a huge shot. They refuse to lose, Indonesia. And with the clock, it's very soon going to become the enemy. Tucker, Abbas, will it be another three? Oh boy, rimmed out.
And that's a huge rebound for Bolden. That was a tough rebound as well. Did a great job on sealing out Al-Bawri.
Zapatero for three.
That's a bad decision. That's a poor decision. Understandable, but not the right decision.
Well, nobody was there for the rebound either. There he is, Gatling and Ibrahim.
Ibrahim asking for the foul. Understandable. It was an aggressive stance on the defensive side.
Prestawa comes back into the game. Interesting to see if he redeems himself. Oh boy, that's a tough. They could look at that. It's inside 3 minutes. I'm surprised they didn't appeal. And Abu Hawass, nope. Rebound, Al-Bawri, the ball knocked away. Oh, and it goes off of Prestawa.
Both teams being forced to put everything into this. There's no half measures now. So many different battles that have been intriguing the entire game.
Abu Hawass has had the hot hand. Oh boy, that was a charge, surely. Al-Bawri. And has to throw up a prayer.
We can breathe.
You know, there's a difference in skill level here. Let's be honest with some of these players. What I love about these Indonesian players is, just, you've already touched on it, they don't care. They are going for it.
And it shows how that skill difference can be made up with heart and passion and hustle and just giving everything. It really does. And you said it. International basketball is just up there with some of the best experiences you'll get in the sport as well.
Set the screen. Play. Pass to Marquise.
defense, zone defense. Scratch. Attack. Marquise or Derek. Here. Other guy. Other guy. Here. Corner. Dumps. Dumps. Zone. Man to man. Reverse. Hey.
Go lower and cross spring.
Okay, guys. Hey. Only one. Only one score. We have a tie. We have a tie. Get two possessions.
I mean, Ibrahim is complaining about that play, but hey, this is, it's like, it's international basketball. You got to take some contact sometimes, you know?
Yeah, the non-contact sport that has plenty of contact, that's for sure.
That was a huge shot from Bolden.
Interesting time out there from Coach Pešić, though, clearly saying, we've got to put the ball in his hands. We've got to put the ball in Bolden's hands.
Bolden's got 16 and 13.
He's a big-time player. This is a big-time moment. He has more experience than the rest of the players on the floor right now, and they have to lean into that experience.
He hasn't had much food to eat tonight, but what he has had, he's eaten it. You got to go back to him. Prestawa back to Bolden for three. Oh, rims out. And Javier
to the basket.
Abbas gets it over to Tucker. Boy, unlucky for Bolden.
And now for Jordan to run down the clock. Realistically, just take it down to 4 or 5 seconds before you make a move. Even if you get a poor shot away,
well, I'd still be happy. Seconds. Tucker, does he know it? Oh, he's going to put up a prayer. Nope, he's going to get it. They're not going to get the shot off.
That's not great, but it's not the end of the world. They've taken 24 seconds off the game clock. They're still two possessions ahead with a little over a minute to go. It's not ideal, but it's better that that happens than they take a poor shot with plenty of seconds on the game clock. See, Ibrahim should be stepping up and making him pick the ball up. They shouldn't be letting him progress that.
I think they've opened the door here just a little bit more for Indonesia. But now Prestawa turns it over again.
You just don't know where he was dribbling. He was dribbling into trouble. And this is the inexperience showing for Indonesia.
Al-Ghawari for three. Oh, that's the dagger that has killed this game.
And who else to deliver than Al-Ghawari?
And Al-Ghawari with the rebound. And that has sealed the fate of Indonesia tonight.
But listen to that reaction. Listen to that reaction. That's such a wonderful reaction. Their team have lost. But because of the effort the players have put in, they're giving, the crowd are giving everything back to their players. An amazing night for Indonesian basketball, even with this loss.
It really is. A great night for the FIBA Asia Cup. Great night for Al-Ghawari, for Abbas, who played very well, Abu Halas, Alhar Marche. A great night for Jordan. This was a very, very difficult environment, but they have survived, winning it 74-65.
Time to take stock at the end of what has been, yeah, the best game, I think, within the Asia Cup so far. We knew it was going to be a good game. We thought the Jordan were going to be favourites for this game. They were. But my goodness me, Indonesia gave it everything. And their three-point shooting, it cost them in the second half, really, but it kept them so competitive in that first half. Jordan winning the rebounding battle. Al-Ghawari doing a great job. Al-Sharmashe just coming in and getting a huge amount of effort onto the floor. And, wow, breathtaking.
You know, the holes are there. They're obvious for Indonesia. You know, their attention to rebounds, their decision-making at times.
Yeah,
they get
composure.
Into a rush.
Yeah.
And they have to be able to adapt. But the one thing that's there is the courage and the desire to get better and to make basketball, to give it a legacy here that everybody will be proud of and something that they can build on for the future. And I don't think there's any question about it. They're moving that way. But now the reality is, I think they're probably going to end up facing the likes of China in the qualification for
which
the
is a big ask.
Which is a huge ask.
That's a really big ask. And they kept leaning on the three, even though it deserted them in the third quarter. There was moments in the game and I was pleading with them, saying go to the basket, go inside, but they still, we see Grajita hitting the three. They still managed to bail themselves out from range. They still used that perimeter game to get themselves in a position where they could at least strike in the closing stages. And you have nothing but respect for what Indonesia have done today. But it's the experience for me of Jordan that won the day in the end.
I'm surprised, really, Indonesia only had 14 turnovers. It's just that the turnovers, some of them came at the worst time. And Jordan scoring 16 points off of those turnovers. So they made more of their chances in that respect. And so it was costly, but at the end of the day as well, you got to really tip your hat as we look at the highlights of this second half. You got to tip your hat to so many players in that Jordan team.
Yeah.
Abu Hawass came right out in the second half and said, I'm going to be a factor in this game because Jordan needs me. Freddie Ibrahim as well. You had Alhar Marche. I mean, how many times did we say, wow, what a contribution. 5 points to go with his 7 rebounds. He was always there getting a big rebound. And then you had particularly Abbas, the captain, who was taken out, didn't look too happy, but then he came back out. Couple big plays late in the game. The jump shot, that's one of them right there, taking it and making it. And then with his penetration from the corner on the baseline and then getting it to Al-Dawari for the dunk. That one right there. Those were two massive plays for Jordan, and it was Abbas who pulled the strings.
Yeah, it was, and it was their experience. It's their collective experience from Jordan. And you said it in commentary, and you're absolutely right. They thrived in this environment as well. You could almost see a little wry smile on their face, you know, playing the villains on the court. But they kind of fed on that animosity that the crowd were throwing them at times. Phenomenal, absolutely phenomenal from both teams. They put on an amazing game of basketball, the best in the Asia Cup so far this year. And for Jordan, it was a must-win game. And yeah, as you say, it now puts Indonesia in a position that it makes it tougher for them to get to that quarterfinal that secure them World Cup qualification, but it doesn't make it impossible.
Well, Al-Dawari, I think he answered the call today. 12 points, incredible game, 16 rebounds. So look at the standings: Australia, Indonesia, and Jordan now 1-1. Saudi Arabia 0-2. Australia winning earlier today, and of course in this one, 74-65. Jordan ruined the party in Jakarta, at least for tonight, or maybe they're just setting up more drama for the days ahead. So on this incredible game, we saw Javiero, we saw Bolden, we saw Zapatero, we saw Grajita come out and play some outstanding basketball, but it was the likes of Abu Hawass and Jordan who won the day.